But to start with, the thing that just strikes me is this whole distinction between deed and idea is a very Hegelian concept. And then in the wake of it, you know, Marxist. And it's actually very surprising at first to see that Reconstruction is actually, especially its first two or three chapters, are very Hegelian. So at some point we would have to talk some basic Hegel, because without having some concept of Hegel, it is very hard to understand this book. The second thing is, and I mean, it's surprising in the sense that, you know, there's so much emphasis on science and empiricism and observation and all that. Not only in this book, but also there's a lot of emphasis on deed and concrete and action as opposed to ideas in Iqbal's poetry as well, and which is not very surprising given the, you know, the background of imperialism and struggle against it. But what is surprising at the start is this Hegelian element. Because Hegel is anything but concrete. He's a speculative philosopher par excellence. If you know a bit of background, you know, Iqbal did study philosophy at the University of Government College, Lahore, and then he went to Cambridge, I think, and I don't remember the exact date, but early 20th century. So Hegelianism is very, or British Hegelianism, is still, you know, around. And one of the, and then Iqbal went to Germany, although he wrote his dissertation on the development of metaphysics in Persia, but his knowledge of German philosophy and German culture cannot be underestimated. So, you know, it is not surprising that he knows Hegel for this very reason. Some of his teachers were, at Cambridge at least, were Hegelians. And I don't know much about his teachers at Government College, Lahore, so not their philosophical background, and it would be interesting to know what was the curriculum at Government College, Lahore at the time, the philosophy curriculum. Anyhow, and also, you know, Marxism and communism is all rage at the time, so he could not have known Marx. You know, he must deal with Marx, and he does in his poetry and as well as his thoughts. So if you know Marx, then, you know, Hegel is not far away. So on the one hand, Hegelian connections are, on the face of it, a bit strange or a bit surprising, but when we delve deep into it, then it becomes obvious that the connections are not that far-fetched. So, just to go back, let's go back to the Quran is a book which...